Hey, I'm Rons, and have you ever wondered if there was something like an AIO in the custom water cooling scene? Well, today is your lucky day, where we'll be taking a look at the Barrow 3-in-1 CPU block, pump, and rest combo, and show you its features, its internals, and how it could be part of your next build. And as always, links of everything you see in this video will be in the description below. Well, the block comes in a pretty basic black box. The only identifier is the label on the side, which specifies this is the AMD bracket version. Barrow does not include the Intel bracket in the box, rather they sell the AM4, LGA and X299 blocks separately. They also have separate blocks for the PMMA and the acrylic one. So make sure you choose the right model when you make the purchase. Opening it up, you can see there is quite a lot of foam protection. Not particularly of high quality ones, but it does the job. On the side, covered with yet more foam, is the cable that connects to the block. We will take a detailed look at this a bit later in the video. We also get a pair of hex screwdrivers, some cheap thermal paste, please do not use this one, the mounting screws with normal springs, and some extra longer springs. Then finally we have the block itself. As mentioned earlier, this is the CPU block with the pump and reservoir. The non-removable ARGB cable is attached to the block, which lights up the ARGB strip that goes all the way around the inside of the block. On the side metal plate, it's laser engraved with the label specifying fill, inlet and outlet ports of the block. Just note that the fill and inlet port can be used interchangeably as they are both connected to the reservoir part of the block, while the outlet is separate altogether. As this is the acrylic model, it's pretty transparent and you can see all the insides of the block. Important thing to note is that you need to buy this cable separately, which converts the group 3 pin of the Barrow ARGB strip to the split 3 pin port that you can connect directly to the motherboard's ARGB pins. Otherwise, you'll have to buy the controller Barrow sells separately. I'll put the links to these items in the description below. Now that I have connected the cable, we can see some lighting effects in the background while I read out the dimensions of the pump. Mainly you have 3 quarter inch ports where you can connect your standard water cooling fittings. And the other important dimensions to remember is that it is 85mm wide and 73.5mm tall. Take a note of the dimensions, as it will be important to plan your custom loop and clearances if you plan on using this block in a small form factor ITX size PC cases. There are 4 LEDs on the longer side and 3 on the shorter side. So there is a total of 14 LEDs on the block. So before I start opening it up, let's first disconnect the ARGB cable. You can use the hex screwdriver provided in the box, which I showed you earlier, or in my case I'll be using the Mi Wow stick, which is a handy dandy electronic screwdriver to make my life easier. We just have to undo the 4 screws on the top 4 corners, which have 2 washers underneath each of them. With this we can remove the top part, which houses the OLED display. This part is connected to the circuit board below through a cable. Be careful not to break it. With this, you can change the orientation of the OLED display on the top based on how you want it. However, in my case, I'll be leaving it as it is. And that's my little angel helping me out. Now let's look at the pump specs. This is a good DDC pump. And from what I've noticed by comparing with EK's DDC pump specs, this is 1 watt lower in power. However, the maximum flow rate is only slightly lower, 960 liters per hour to EK's 1000 liters per hour. Just as an additional info, if you do require to change the pump, that is also possible. Now let's turn over and have a look at the cold plate. It has a protective sticker with Barrow company logo and some safety text saying to remove this sticker before using the block. All you have to do is peel off this sticker, which thankfully is the simplest thing to do, and it leaves no residue. Then we go about undoing the four screws at the four corners, and after that the cold plate just comes off. The cold plate itself is pretty heavy. Though they haven't mentioned anywhere in the documentation, it's quite clear this is a nickel plated copper cold plate. The documentation, however, specifies the fin density of the cold plate, which is about 49 micro jetting waterways in about 3 cm². I just got to say that the machining on this is pretty amazing. Now to the mounting bracket. Removing the mounting bracket gives you access to the LED strip below. Let's see if we can change the orientation of this as well. Well, I guess that's a no, as the mounting screw holes get blocked by the reservoir. So there is only one possible way this can be mounted onto the block. Back to the cold plate. It has a lovely mirror finish to it, so this will give the best possible contact with the CPU plate. Before we put it all back, we have to make sure the micro jetting waterway is perpendicular to the pump jet plate. And then we screw the four corners back, and that's it. So in conclusion, the only way you can change the orientation of the OLED display is to remove the top four screws and turn it and set it in your desired position. Now finally coming back to the cables. There's a single port where you can connect the cable into the block. On the other end, you will find it split into three parts. One, the Molex part. This is mainly how the pump gets its power. Two, the PWM port. Connect this port to any of your motherboard PWM header. You will be able to run the pump in PWM mode or monitor the pump feed through the motherboard software. Finally, three, a port that connects to your motherboard's power button header and a bypass that connects to your PC case power button cable. This is a safety feature called protection mode for automatically shutting down the system if the pump fails. We have three buttons on the top. Two buttons to manually decrease and increase the speed of the pump. If you press them together, we can switch from the PWM mode to the manual mode. The third button, named auto, is to turn off and on the protection mode, which I mentioned earlier. The OLED display will show the pump's RPM in manual mode, the speed will be faded, and a letter P will show up designating that the pump is in PWM mode. On the top right, we will find if the protection mode is on or off. Finally, on the sides, we will see venting for passively cooling the pump motor. Like I mentioned before, this block comes in several variations. I'll just take you through them. You have two options, going with the acrylic one or the PMMA one. The PMMA one is the completely black model, and the acrylic one is the see-through one. You can get two options in each of them. You can get one with the OLED display, like the one we are showing over here, and one without the OLED display that you can see in the video shown by Optimum Tech. Then you have the several brackets. So all these models comes with either the AMD or the Intel or the X299 motherboard brackets. You have to buy them separately. You may be able to ask the supplier in AliExpress for the brackets separately to buy. They might be able to provide you that. In conclusion, this is a decent block from Barrow. It's even endorsed by popular trustworthy YouTubers like Optimum Tech and Austin Events. Links to both their videos where they use this in their builds will be in the description below. I will be posting a future video to show how to install this block onto your motherboard. If you'd like to see that, stay tuned, it won't be long till I post that. I will put the link in the description below or in the pop-up in the top right corner. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click the bell icon to be notified of my future videos. Stay home, if not, wear a mask and protect yourself and your family members. That's all for now. Take care. Bye-bye.